Hello everyone, welcome to Analog IAS. Today we are going to discuss about local self-government. The important committees that worked on local self-government are Balwant Rai Mehta Committee, Ashok Mehta Committee, G.V.K. Rao Committee and L.M. Singhvi Committee. Let us first see rural local self-government. The 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act was passed in 1992 and is known as the Panchayats. It consists of articles 243 to 243O. Also, Part 9 and 11 schedule were added to this constitution. The Act provides for a three-tier system, that is panchayats at village, intermediate and district levels. Also, the provisions of Part 9 are not applicable to 5th schedule areas. The Parliament has enacted Panchayats Extension to Scheduled Areas Act 1996, also known as PISA Act, to provide self-rule for bulk of tribal population, also to safeguard and to preserve traditions and customs of tribal communities. Now let us discuss about urban local self-government. The 74th Constitutional Amendment Act was passed in 1992, known as Municipalities. It consists of articles 243P to 243ZG. Also, Part 9A and 12 schedule were added to the constitution. The act provides for three types of municipalities: Nagar Panchayats, which is an area in transition from rural area to urban areas, Municipal Council for a smaller urban area, Municipal Corporation for a larger urban area. Some of the other provisions are: the act provides for reservation of seats for scheduled type, scheduled caste and scheduled tribes in every panchayat in proportion of their population. Also, it provides reservation of not less than one-third of total number of seats for women, including the number of seats reserved for women belonging to SCs and STs. The Act also provides for a 5-year term of office. Now, let us see a previous year question based on this. The local self-government can be best explained as an exercise in A. Federalism. This is false, because local bodies are not federal entities like state. Option C. Administrative delegation. This is also false, because they are political entities unlike administrative entities. Option D. Direct democracy. It involves election and indirect decision making by people's representatives. So this statement is false. Option B. Democratic decentralization. This is true, because decentralization and grassroots empowerment are core guiding principles of local self-government. So the answer is B. Thank you.